there was one year someone told me that I played 180 shows, and of course, that doesn't include rehearsals and travel days and recording. So it's a lot. I started playing in bars and nightclubs when I was 14 years old, which these days I don't think you could get away with, and I wouldn't recommend it to someone anyway. But in those days, in the 70s, it was a little more acceptable. My only actual day job, working at KFC when I was 15, and I got laid off because I was working too many hours at that young age, and they said, when you turn 16, you can come back to work. And before I turned 16, I had joined a band that was doing a few gigs here and there, and I never went back. There's two facets to being on stage with someone you grew up listening to or you really greatly admire. One is just the feeling of being there regardless of what happens. Then the extra special icing on the cake is if that turns into some amazing music, which just pushes it over the top. It's very spontaneous, especially at these festivals. Whoever's hanging around, we have these conversations backstage. In a lot of cases, it's like a little family reunion, and you figure out who's going to be around, and let's have some fun. Bring on the music. I never met Jerry Garcia. I saw him play five or six times, and I had the opportunity to meet him. I was backstage at a few Dead shows, but I always told myself that I didn't want to be in the way. I didn't want to intrude on his space, and I'll meet him next time. And of course, there wasn't a next time. And it was a similar thing for me with Stevie Ray Vaughan. I had several opportunities to meet Stevie, and it was the same thing. I was not wanting to be in the way. I'll meet him next time. I think the lesson learned from that is if you really want to meet someone, then introduce yourself. What's the worst that could happen?